Greetings to fellow Fright Fiends, and thanks for dropping by the Horror Zone. I hope everyone's doing well today. This is a video that I wasn't planning on doing. This was something that I thought wasn't going to arrive until after Christmas, but it arrived a couple days early. It was something that I sought out after getting some Christmas money, some early Christmas money. This has been an item I've been waiting for literally over a year now. It was first announced back in 2018. I believe it was fall of 2018. And it's probably one of the last Friday the 13th collectibles that we're going to get until after the lawsuit is settled between Victor Miller and Sean S. Cunningham. Now, Friday the 13th Part 3 in 3D is one of the first Friday the 13th movies that I ever saw in completion. Full, you know, I had seen Part 2, but I saw Part 3 many more times. And the dream sequence at the end of the film, where Chris is in the canoe, she sees Jason completely unmasked with, you know, blood on his face and the axe mark from the barn, you know, and he's in the house and he rushes towards her and she tries to get away from him in the canoe. And then all of a sudden he's gone, and then the corpse of Mrs. Voorhees bursts out of Crystal Lake and grabs Chris and pulls her into the water, out of the canoe and into the water. That scene terrified me for years. Much more so, even more so than the original jump scare of Jason grabbing Alice in the canoe in the first film. That, I don't know what it was, but the look of Mrs. Voorhees with the worms coming out of her face and her head all decomposed and just the look and just this old woman jumping out of the lake and grabbing Chris scared the shit out of me. Yeah, that scene terrified me, and I was really surprised that they were going to be putting out a figure of that light. This is the first Mrs. Voorhees figure that they have put out since the San Diego Comic-Con exclusive. I believe it was 2014-2015, which I do have. I have it up here on the Friday the 13th wall. That was one that a friend of mine got for me at Comic-Con, and that one is very rare right now. That one comes with Jason, the young Jason, which is the only time that they have done an official release of that likeness. But this one is called, I believe it's called The Lady in the Lake, or The Woman in the Lake. It doesn't say, I don't ever remember it saying, you know, like Pamela Voorhees. It just said Lady in the Lake. And I want to thank my friend, Kevin, House of Mysterious Secrets, for getting this for me. I reached out to him because I wasn't finding it in stores. I wasn't seeing it anywhere available. He was able to get me one. Thank you so much, Kevin. You rock. Check out House of Mysterious Secrets. I'll put a link down below. Best place to buy horror collectibles. I've been buying collectibles from him for nearly 10 years now. Cannot recommend them enough. And this is something that I've been waiting for. And of course, I know it's a little dark right here, but I will be showcasing this up close so you guys can see this. This will be staying in the package. All of the retro NECA figures I keep in the package. Everyone that's come out from the Friday the 13th line that I've picked up. But this is amazing. She looks awesome. The art, the backer card is done by Jason Edmonston, who I think is a fantastic artist. This is an amazing collectible, one that I am so happy to have here in the Horror Zone. It was a terrific surprise that it arrived so early. Thank you again, Kevin, for getting this for me. I hope everyone enjoyed this video. Again, I will spin the camera around now so you guys can see this up close. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. And I hope everyone is doing well. Merry Christmas again, and I'll talk to you guys later. Take it easy. Stay scared as always. want to thank everyone for taking this time to drop by the Horror Zone. It really means a lot to me that people are supporting what I do here. If you like this video, please hit the subscribe button down below. I upload videos at least once or twice a week. It would really mean a lot if people would spread the word about this channel. This is a passion of mine. I love the horror genre, and I'm really happy to share my love of it with all of you. So thanks so much again for checking it out, and I'll talk to you guys later. Take it easy.